Still waiting. Yeah, we are online. So welcome everyone to the Google Hangout of Mahindra Eco Central College of Engineering with Professor Prabhakar Singh. Professor Prabhakar Singh is a professor of civil and mechanical engineering here. Professor Singh, would you like to say a few words about your work at MEC?
Thank you, Pranay. My name is Prabhakar Singh and I'm a civil engineer here. I've joined at an associate professor. I have done my schooling and BTech from Bihar, and then I went for Masters in IIT Kharagpur. My area of expertise was Water Resource Development Management. After my Masters, I went to US, Washington State University for my PhD in Land and Water Engineering. And after completing my PhD, I did research work for 4 years as a postdoctoral researcher, and then I came back to India. I joined Galgotia's, and then in February 2014, I joined Mahindra Eco Central. And I'm ready for the question and answer.
Thank you, Professor Singh. This is the first question is about your area of research and your study. This is Uma. She's asked a question. Your research was about land and water engineering. How was that like, and what impact does that have on the environment?
Yes, if you go for land and water, it's one of the main in the environment, right? What do you understand by when you say environment? It's just not the air pollution, right? Environment consists of all the surroundings you have. So land and water engineering is one of the main, because water pollution happens through all the wastewater we dump into the ground or in the river, and it percolates and mix into the groundwater. So the drinking water get polluted. So that's again a kind of environmental hazard. The same way the solid waste we dump in the ground become infertile. That's again environmental impact. And those waste, they produce harmless gases. And some other, there are many other sources for air pollution. So it's directly affect the environment. So my area of land and water engineering, yes, it is in the environmental area. Pranay?
Yeah, thanks for that answer, Prabhakar sir. I have one question on behalf of one of my colleagues here. From your perspective, looking at the present situation in our country, in India, what do you see the scope and relevance of civil engineering, and how far-reaching do you think are the opportunities and avenues for pursuing a rewarding career through civil engineering in India?
Okay, so let me just say that for civil engineers, right now it's the boom. Why? That if you just roam around all over the India, all you see is the construction. Construction is just going on like anything. So construction means civil engineers, first thing. Second, if I move from construction a little bit on the environmental side, you will find that everywhere, all the talks, it's happening on air pollution, water pollution, those things. So all the big funding coming from the World Bank or other, they are taking care of that, cleaning the river, cleaning clean water for drink, all those. So there is a lot of funding coming in that area too. And if I go a little further on that, scarcity of drinking water. To take care of that, you need water treatment plants, you need dams in certain areas to store the water, and these all things require a lot of money, and we are getting a lot of funding also from government and the world organizations, and this work will be taken care of by the civil engineers. So in my opinion, civil engineers are good to go for at least 10 years, 20 years for sure.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for that. Thank you for that very good answer. This is a follow-up question from your on your work.
That's an interesting answer.
And there's another follow-up question on your work, sir. That somebody has written, my niece is interested in engineering as well as environmental studies. Can you tell me what stream of engineering she should pursue? for this type of research?
Sorry, let me understand the question. Are you saying that C12 studies the environmental studies?
Yeah, engineering as well as environmental studies. Your interests are in engineering as well as environmental studies. So, what stream of engineering should you take for pursuing both of these together?
Yeah, in my opinion, the best will be go through civil engineering. Like in MEC, we have 4 years of civil engineering, right? And the fifth year we have thrust area of environmental. So through civil engineering, going through environmental side, that will be the best, in my opinion, instead of going for mechanical or other branches. As a civil engineer, you will understand many things that take care of all the infrastructure and what the problem happening right now. And the environmental side will tell you, okay, let me backtrack a little bit. I think if you are not an engineer, I think chemistry background will also help. My previous answer was for someone who is an engineer. He wanted to be engineer. So from civil engineering, if you are going environmental side, that's the best track for me. If you are not an engineer, for the BSc and all, that chemistry will be a better, because all the chemical analysis and all those finding the treatment and stuff, that will take care of by the chemistry background. But for the engineer, I think civil engineer and then environmental studies will be the best. I hope I answered it correctly.
Yes, yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah. There is a question actually directly for you. This is, how did you get to know about MEC? And do you think there is any risk for a professor to join a new college? This is actually directly aiming for you, like asking you that question.
Okay. In my, how I came to know about it, actually, I saw the ad in the newspaper, because during that time I was looking for a new job. So I was going through all the Accent and other web pages. Suddenly one day I saw the ad on the newspaper that there is a new university, Mahindra Call Central, is opening, and they are looking for resumes. So for me personally, Mahindra term worked a lot because I know the name for a long time. So that worked for me. And just to let you know, I didn't feel a little bit that I'm going in a wrong place or I'm scared. I was confident that if the name Mahindra is there, there is certain, how should you say, confidence you get that, okay, this is a well-known company, and if he's coming into the education line, it will start at a above level, not the other private university. So for me, it was no risk, for sure. I was sure that I'm going into the right place.
Thank you for that very good answer, sir. This Aman, who's age 19, so his interest is in automobile engineering specifically. So he's like, his question is, sir, for automobile engineering, what should we do, or what should we study?
For automobile engineering, let me think a little bit. I think there nowadays many universities or colleges, they are providing automobile engineering from the very basic. But I'm not sure how helpful it will be, because in my opinion, if you go through mechanical engineering first 4 years and then you move into the automobile, that will be much better, in my opinion. That's my just opinion. As in a civil engineer, I'm not a mechanical or automobile engineer. But I think, because as a mechanical engineer, you learned a lot of things, and for a long time, that has been the trend that most of the mechanical engineers, they become the automobile engineers. So as being a little older, I can say that that should be the case. But if you really want to be automobile engineer and you can find a really good university where they are starting from scratch, I think that should work too. But it's just my opinion.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for that answer. So there's another question regarding to the course. This is from Mr. Brahma, who's a parent, who's age 15.
Okay.
He says that many engineering students opt for MS in USA after completing a 4-year engineering degree in India. But MEC is offering a 5-year degree. Does that pose any challenges if they get a dual degree? Does that pose any challenges for further study outside India? That's what his question is.
No, I don't think so. Because see, most of the time after BTEC you go for MS, like it's a master degree. So you are looking for a master's degree, that's why you are going to US. But here you are getting BTEC and MTEC both. So it should not be a problem. And after the MTEC degree, because we have a very good curriculum, so I think you won't be having problem if you want to go for a PhD, because after dual degree you can directly start PhD, in my humble opinion. But if you want to do again MS, that's your personal choice, but I think it should not be any problem if you are having dual degree, because it's well recognized for sale.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for that answer. There's another question from Mr. Satya here. In many engineering colleges, the curriculum is good, but the students do not have any time when it comes to other activities such as sports and recreation. How different will MEC be? That is one part of the question. And the other thing is, what is all-round development important for becoming an engineer? That's the second part of the question.
Okay, let me understand first the question properly. That he is looking for the extracurricular activities like sports and other cultural activities?
Yes.
Right? Okay.
Yes. And the second part is, how important is all-round development for an engineer?
Okay. So first let me go for the extracurricular activities. I think in our, recently we are working on the timetable and all, and we are working that students should get enough time for their curricular activities. And we came up with a plan that we will encourage the students to start the clubs like, if somebody is in drama, they can start a drama club, and there will be a group of four students, they will work. Just like there will be a sports club, maybe tennis club. And we came up with the decision that we'll just encourage them, and those clubs will be taken care of by the students only. So they will be the whole and soul of the club to do that. So we are going to provide support to the students to do the extracurricular activities for sure. Now, second question was, can you repeat the second question, sorry?
Yeah, the second question is, how important is all-round development for an engineer?
I think for an engineer to be a better entrepreneur or successful, he needs an all-round development, not the all-round development for an engineer. With engineer, as an engineer, if you have all-round development with the personality and all, it will help you later on in the life. Either you are going in the business side, opening a company, because whenever you are going in the world, as they say that whatever you are learning in the BTEC class, you use only 20-30% the engineering knowledge. But most of the engineering colleges here, they don't provide a lot of social activities or your communication skill. They don't give so much emphasis on that, rather just give you very depth knowledge of the subjects. Here what we are trying to do, that we are trying to give you all the things that you need to become a better person and as a better businessman, or you can say innovator. Means we are just going to provide you all support, not just the engineering background.
Thank you for that answer, sir. This next question is about
yes, Praveen.
Yeah, just to add to what Professor has spoken, Pranay, I think we all know how hard students work through those 2 years after their 10th standard to get into a good college. You know, they are probably the hardest years of their life, and they sacrifice everything, all social activities, all fun and connect, and totally dedicate themselves to studies so that they get good ranks and get into a good engineering or a medical or a management institution. So I think it is very important that we put these students back in touch with various other activities, whether they are social activities, humanities, even philosophy, a bit of soul searching, you know, a bit of creative sciences, a bit of expressionism, drama. All these things add up to making them a 360 degree individual once again.
Thank you for adding to that, Praveen.
Thank you, Praveen.
The next question is actually on the civil engineering market in India. So one of somebody asks, is it advisable to work in India after graduation or try international companies to work for? And how big is the market in India?
How big is the market in India for civil engineering? I just told you it's really big right now, and I think I can say for next 10 years it's going to be like that, because all the big cities, they are expanding, and when the expansion starts, means you have building, water supply system, water storage, and all the construction work. Either you are in constructing the steel factory if you are working, it's everywhere, or iron factory, everywhere. It's all expanding, and next 10 years, I'm seeing a very good future for civil engineering for sure. And that another part, sorry, what was the another part of the question?
The other part is it
international? Okay. For the international, see, the thing is, for working national and international, is that when you go to any international company or university, you learn a lot of things, what's happening around the world. So I will say it's more of a personal choice, but I will advise, if you get a chance to go to the international company or university, please go, because it will give you a broader perspective. When you work, you see the different problems, how they are solving, how we are solving. And that's one of the part that when you will come to Mahindra Eco Central, you will get to see that, because our aim is that when you are studying here, doing internship also, we'll try to get you in the international companies. And as I know, as far as the information I have, for 6 months, you will be in Mahindra Eco Central Paris. So if you go there and see before you graduate all these things, I'm sure you would like to work in the international company. If not, Indian companies are really good too. Praveen, would you like to add something?
Yeah, I'd like to clarify, not necessarily Ecole Centrale Paris, 6 months of internship at an external location. It could be one of our affiliate companies, it could be an Indian company, or it could be a European company. The student would have enough choices to choose, select that which would, suit
right.
His
situation
the best.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for that explanation. There's another question regarding to your subject. How important, or what is the contribution of engineers to clean water storage and supply, with regards to like things like how we are coming up with new cities? One of the major challenges will be the supply of clean drinking water. So what are the challenges, or what is the way forward in that, for engineers, or how would they deal with such an issue?
Okay, the thing is that the water treatment plant, nowadays you will find that in all the big cities on the outskirts, you will learn that the water treatment plant is there. I don't know how many of them are working correctly, but if they are working, that's what they do. They treat the water. First, it will be the river water. They will try to make it drinkable. And in that water treatment plant, all the processes that takes place, taking out the soluble contaminants and then heavy contaminants. There's different part of contaminants that is in the water, dirty or wastewater. So you have to clean one by one on the different processes. That's where we need the engineers to take care of that. So all the treatment plants, they need civil engineers, environmental engineers to take care of the treating of the water, wastewater, river water, groundwater. Nowadays, the big problem with groundwater is that last like 20, 30 years, we'll use lots of fertilizers, and some of those fertilizers are percolates and mixed into the groundwater, and those are not good for the drinking. So nowadays, even the groundwater has to be treated. So that's why you see that most of the houses now, the rich people who can afford, they use RO at their home because they want to drink clean water, even if they are getting groundwater. So that's my answer.
So another question with regards to structural engineering specifically. This is a question asked by...
Excuse me, I think Praveen wants to say something.
Yeah. I just wanted to add that on the one hand, civil engineers and civil engineering is helping set up new cities, expand infrastructure, ensure that villages are becoming towns, towns are becoming cities, cities are becoming mega cities. On the one hand, civil engineering is helping do all this, and on the other hand, the side effects of such growth and expansion which are in a sense negative in many ways, like depletion of water, you know, the ground table going down, and mm-hmm. the pollution and contamination, industrial effluents. So on the other hand, on the other side, civil engineering is also helping to neutralize the side mm-hmm. effects of growth.
Yeah.
So it's an interesting thing, you know, civil engineering.
Yeah. Very well put, Praveen. Very well put.
Sir, there is another question from Mr. Nabil. It's about structural engineering. So this is with regards to actually all the metro projects that, so basically it's like there are a lot of metro rail projects that are happening in around India, as well as mm-hmm. there's a very big project happening in Hyderabad. What is the what is the feasibility of such mega projects? That is one question. The other thing is that how can efficient engineering make these projects better? That's the other part of the question.
See, the thing is, in my opinion, that engineer's job is to make efficient all the tough projects, because if it just has to do by hand and without efficiency, it will just keep going on for years and years. So as an engineer, your job is to make sure that, okay, this is a big project, it will take a long time. So just to make sure that how we can be more efficient in completing these projects. Now, as a structural engineer, what you can do, that I'm just thinking out loud, that most of the time you will see that in India, everywhere if you go, the structure is very similar, right? All the metro structures that they are building, it's almost the same. If you are good and you are a good innovator, you can come up with a new design that will be more efficient, that will last much longer. So that will be a good way to contribute in these big projects. That's my opinion.
Thank you, sir. We are actually done with our set of questions.
Okay.
And we have completed all of what we have answered, about 8 or 10 questions from our participants.
Okay.
And if you have anything else to add with regards to what MEC has to offer, in what you have to offer, or what is your, if you would like to expand on your research area, what you would like to do at MEC specifically, what would be your next 5-year plan at MEC for research or for teaching? If you could share that, then that would be great.
Yeah, sure. First, let me talk about what I'm going to teach here. That in the first semester, I'm planning to teach on the engineering design portion, and then later on, I will teach subjects like fluid mechanics and hydraulics, water resources. Those subjects I'll be teaching in the Mahindra EcoCentral. Regarding research work, the research work I did in the US, that was more very specific to their own climate. My most of the research work was on snow melt, the effect of snow on the ground, how it will affect the erosion, those things. And second was water movement in the soil profile. But after coming India, I'm thinking of shifting a little bit to the water treatment area. But when I say water treatment, I doesn't mean that I want to set up a plant, treatment plant. What I'm planning to do is to start a survey kind of project that collects samples of the, suppose for the Hyderabad area, the big Hyderabad area, I can select three things. One, if all the wastewater effluent that's mixing in the river, I will collect samples of all those areas, samples of groundwater, and samples of drinking water that has been providing to the citizen of the Hyderabad, and try to find out how much contaminant they have and how we can modify that. That's my basic one. Second, recently I talked to Professor Didier, our Dean Academics from France, and there is a good chance that I will have a collaboration with some scientists from Ecole Centrale Paris too. But it hasn't been started, but just in a preliminary round, that if it works out, then I will be doing some research work with them. But here, my main emphasis will be on the water treatment related research. Pranay?
Yeah, thank you Professor Prabhakar Singh for joining us in the Hangout, and It was a very informative session about civil engineering and engineering in general as well, especially your work that is happening, especially in water engineering, which is a relatively unheard of field, especially in India. So we hope that I'd like to thank you for joining us. I'd like to thank Praveen for joining us as well. And we will be having a next hangout with Professor Salome. And it will be next week on next Tuesday. And hope to see everybody there. Thank you, sir. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Pranay. I would like to just add one thing that thank you very much for arranging this hangout session. And I hope my answers were good enough for the all the people who asked the questions. And just in case if somebody has any other question and they want to send me an email or anything, I'm good. Okay. And thank you, Praveen, for taking care of some of the questions and adding to. It was really nice hearing you.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Mm-hmm.